Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, good morning all. Welcome to the fourth meeting of English for Economic Studies. Okay, today, yeah, you will learn the material talking about production. So, let's start our material from reading, yeah. So, just as well, please follow my reading, yeah. Today we will talk about the world is flat. Okay, come on, please follow me to read this text, yeah. So it will help you to increase your pronunciation skill. Okay, the world is flat. The Dell theory stipulates no two countries that are both part of a major global supply chain like Dell's will ever fight a war against each other as long as they are both part of the same global supply chain, because people aimed in major global supply change don't want to fight all-time wars anymore. They want to make just-in-time deliveries of goods and services and enjoy the rising standards of living that come with that. One of the people with the best feel for the logic behind this theory is Michael Dell, the founder and chairman of Dell. These countries understand the risk premium that they have, said Dell of the countries in his Asian supply chain. They are pretty careful to protect the equity they have built up. Or tell us why we should not worry. There is lot of truth to this. Countries whose workers and industries are woven into a major global supply chain know that they can take an hour, a week, a month off for war without disrupting industries and economies around the world, and thereby risking the loss of their place in that supply chain for a long time, which could be extremely costly. For a country with no natural resources, being part of global supply chain is like streaking oil, oil that never runs out, and therefore getting dropped from such a chain because you start a war is like having your oil wells go dry, or having someone pour cement down them. They will not come back anytime soon. You are going to pay for it dearly, said Glenn E. Nealon, Senior Vice President for Procurement at Dell. When I asked him what would happen to a major supply chain member in Asia that decided to start fighting with its neighbor and disrupt the supply chain, if you follow the evolutions of supply chain, added Nealon, You see the prosperity and stability they promoted first in Japan and then in Korea and Taiwan. And now in Malaysia, Singapore, the Philippines, Thailand, and Indonesia. Once countries get end in this global supply chain, they feel part of something much bigger than their own business, he said. Okay? After reading the text, yeah, now it's time for you to write 10 new vocabularies. Okay, so this is the first task. Yeah, you can write 10 new words, 10 kosakata baru that you don't know the meaning, yang kalian tidak tahu artinya. Yeah, you write it, yeah, you write them, kalian tulis kata-kata itu, 10 kata itu at the comment column below, di kolom komentar di bawah on YouTube channel. But don't forget, jangan lupa to write your name and your class, untuk menuliskan nama dan kelas. And please, dan tolong wait to post, tunggu untuk mempost, karena because you still have another task. Kamu masih punya, kalian masih punya tugas-tugas yang lainnya. Ya, yeah, so please write 10 new words and then please be patient, tunggu, sabar. Don't post it first. Jangan dulu di-post. Okay, let's continue to the next materials. Okay, now this is the prepositions of time. This is the new materials, yeah. So like you have seen, yeah, in this slide. So there will be any 3 prepositions of time, that is at, on, and in. So when you can use those prepositions, yeah, please check this out. Okay, so okay, from this example, yeah, you can see he saw her in May, he saw her on Tuesday, he saw her at 3 o'clock, yeah. So you have known that there will be any 3 differences, yeah. The first one, in, used for the name of the month. On, it is used for the name of the day. And at, it is used for the time. Do you still remember name of the month? Okay, like for example, like January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December. So all of them, yeah, use in. Okay, then the name of the day, for example, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Yeah, so those days, yeah, use on as the prepositions. And then for the time, it is use at. Okay? Do you got it? Okay, now Please do the second practice. Silahkan kerjakan latihan yang kedua. Ya, please do the second practice. Kerjakan tugas yang kedua. Please write at the comment column below. Okay, silahkan tulis di kolom komentar setelah 10 kosakata baru. Di bawahnya kalian kerjakan 5 nomor ini beserta jawabannya. But remember, tapi ingat, don't post it. Jangan di post terlebih dahulu. Oke, tunggu masih ada tugas yang berikutnya. Oke, let's continue to the next material. If you have completed this task. Kalau kalian sudah menyelesaikan tugas ini, sudah diketik jawabannya, kita bisa masuk ke materi yang berikutnya. Okay. The next is prepositions of place. Okay. So, look at this. Where are they? Okay, so kalian lihat there will be it is rabbit, ya. Ada di manakah posisi rabbitnya? Yes, behind. Okay. So, the rabbit is behind the box. Okay, please follow me. Ikuti bacanya. The rabbit is behind the box. Good. Next. Where is the rabbit now? Okay, where is it? Yes, it is in front of. Okay, just remember, in front of. The rabbit is in front of the box. Okay, please follow me. The rabbit is in front of the box. And now, can you see the rabbit? Okay, can you see? Where is it? Yes, it is in. The rabbit is in the box. The rabbit is in the box. Okay, good. And now, where is it? Yes, next to or beside. The rabbit is next to the box. The rabbit is beside the box. Okay, and now, where is it? Yes, over. The rabbit is over the box. Over. And now, where is it? Yes, between. The rabbit is between the blue box and the red box. Okay, please follow. The rabbit is between the blue box and the red box. Between. And now? Yes. Under. The rabbit is under the table. Where are the sheep? Where is it? Yes. Around. Okay, good job. Around. The sheep are around the box. Di sekeliling. Around. Okay, so where is it? On. Okay. On. Okay. Where is it? In, yes, in. And then this one, in front of. Okay, front. Is it? Ada di mana? Come on. Under. Good job. Under. This is on. Okay. And then. This is between. Good job. Between. Okay, yuk tebak bareng-bareng. This is over. Yes. And then this is in. Good job. In. Then between. Okay. This one around. Okay. This one between and this one around. This is okay. He is in front of the box. He is in the box. Okay, good. Come on, answer ya. She is, yes, between the boxes. He is on the box. She is under the box. Okay, good. Do you have questions? Any other questions? Okay. Okay, now yeah, if you don't have a question, kalau kalian tidak ada pertanyaan, please do the third task. Silahkan kerjakan tugas yang ketiga. So the first task, tadi tugas yang pertama, write 10 new vocabularies. Tuliskan 10 kosakata baru dari reading text-nya. Ya. Yeah. And then the second task ya, yeah, tugas yang kedua itu kalian mengerjakan 5 prepositions of time. Oke. Okay? And now the third task, tugas yang ketiga adalah prepositions of place. Silakan kalian kerjakan prepositions of place-nya ini ya. Yeah. Kalian lihat jawabannya ini berdasarkan gambar di atas ya. This room is my room. My bed is titik-titik ya, bla bla bla, the windows. Berarti ini ya, tempat tidurnya ada di mananya? Jendela nih. Jendelanya ada 2, posisinya ada di mana? Ya, so, tadi kan sudah belajar ada prepositions tuh, ada on, in, over, under, between, beside, between, around, gitu ya. Nah, ditulis jawabannya, kira-kira jawabannya apa? Oke, okay? Sampai 7. Ada 7 nomor di sini. Paham ya? So, dibaca dulu ini soalnya, tulisannya apa. Kemudian dilihat gambarnya. Disesuaikan dengan gambarnya. Oke? Okay? Please do those 3 tasks. Silakan kerjakan 3 tugas tersebut. Pertama, write 10 new vocabularies. Tuliskan 10 kosakata baru. Don't forget to write the meaning of that words. Oke, okay, jangan lupa ditulis artinya apa. Bahasa Indonesianya apa. You are allowed to open dictionary. Kalian boleh membuka kamus kalian. Oke, okay, the second ones, 5 prepositions of time, 5 soal preposition time, and then the third, 7 questions about prepositions of place. Oke, okay? Jadi tugasnya ada 10, 5, dan 7. If you have written all of them, kalau kalian sudah menulis tiga-tiganya nih, 3 tugas tersebut, baru kalian post. Baru kalian post, ya. Jadi, tulis kolom komentarnya itu jangan di-post dulu. Oke? Okay? Tapi kalau kalian sudah terlanjur, kalian bisa hapus dulu, nanti kalian komen lagi, ya. Don't forget to write the name, your name, nama kalian. Jangan lupa di atasnya nama kalian, huruf kapital, nama dan kelas, name and your class. Kalau kalian kelas A, tulis A, kelas B, tulis B, kelas C, tulis C, D atau E juga sama, ya. The name and the class. Oke? Okay? Got it? Oke. Okay. If you have done all of them, yeah, thank you, because the time is up, yeah. See you on the next meeting. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. See you.